I think it's pretty safe to say that when we examine the Skywalker saga, there's a handful of fan favorite characters like Luke, Darth Vader, Mace Windu, and more, such as like Anakin Skywalker, etc. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, the thing with the sequel trilogy is that Disney and Lucasfilm could have done so much more with The Rise of Skywalker than what we received, you know, on the big screen in theaters. There really was a lot more potential to that movie, but as of right now, Disney and Lucasfilm are primarily focused on their new Star Wars universe. In case you guys are tuning in just right now, the new Star Wars universe is essentially going to be a big new Star Wars project that's going to consist of a library's worth of Star Wars material, such as books, novels, comics, video games, TV shows, movies, and a whole lot more on top of all of this that's really going to all interconnect with each other, that's going to be modeled after the MCU. That is Disney's big plan here in order to make it just as big as Marvel, and not just because of the movies, but also everything that happens in the background. Now, with Disney Plus, obviously, in Disney's eyes, this is the future of Star Wars. Apart from their movies, they also want to focus on Disney Plus with their new Star Wars TV shows like The Mandalorian, Kenobi, and of course, others alike around the world that are going to really bring fans all together. They're trying to reunite the fans in order to really make a successful brand of the Star Wars franchise as much as they can. So, with that being said, what's rather intriguing is that now that both Disney and Lucasfilm are currently finished with The Rise of Skywalker and the entire sequel trilogy, they are moving on to their new Star Wars universe, as well as their new Star Wars trilogy of films. It's noted that Disney actually has a big plan for the future of Star Wars and what it holds for the franchise and for the Star Wars community. And that one of those big plans has to do with Disney Plus and their upcoming live-action TV series that is currently in the early development phase, one of which is a Mace Windu TV series that Lucasfilm has been in the talks with Samuel Jackson to reprise his role as Mace Windu once more after the events of Order 66. As of now, it's noted that the Mace Windu TV series would explain not only how Mace was able to survive the fall from the skyscraper on Coruscant, but also exactly how Mace Windu will meet his demise at some point in the upcoming series to explain Mace Windu as a Force Ghost voice in The Rise of Skywalker and why he's dead. It's noted that this series will also introduce a side story of Darth Vader in the mix that Lucasfilm is planning right now, and that they are also looking into introducing brand new Jedi in hiding over in the Outer Rim territory of the galaxy that will become allies with Mace Windu. Now, this new series won't be released until some years from now, but it is also in the early works, and that Lucasfilm is creating a library's worth of Star Wars material, not just for Disney Plus, but also for their new Star Wars universe in general, that is going to take the fans in a different direction. This is said to be Lucasfilm's way of making their TV shows attract some of the older fans as well, and to get more people to join Disney Plus in the near future. So let's go over a couple of parts about this and as to why this really is a big deal for Star Wars. Now, obviously Mace Windu is a beloved character among many fans. In fact, he's one of my fan favorite characters. You know, when I look at Mace Windu portrayed by Sam Jackson in the prequel trilogy, excellent character. I really wish that, you know, they could have done even a little bit more with him in The Phantom Menace than what we received. But he really got his highlight in Revenge of the Sith. There's no doubt about that. Mace Windu really was one of the big highlights of the movie. So, the fact that they're trying to bring him back into this new Star Wars universe in the form of a live-action TV series to explain not exactly how he survived, but ultimately exactly how he will meet his demise in the upcoming TV show. Now, that to me is interesting because you do hear Mace Windu's voice, in case you guys did not know this or missed it, in The Rise of Skywalker. You do hear his voice telling, you know, Rey to, you know, pretty much stay in tune with the Force, and all the Force ghosts are helping her get up to face Palpatine, right? So, the biggest question of all is exactly, how in the world did he survive? Well, George Lucas is the one that actually made it possible that Mace could have very well survived. He actually told Sam Jackson that it is absolutely possible that Mace Windu survived the fall. After all, Jedi can survive, you know, falls from incredible heights. And that is a true fact. And if you look at what happened with Palpatine, he survived the fall. A lot of characters always survive the fall in the Star Wars universe. Granted that Han Solo is an exception. He's the only one that died, you know, when he was pretty much thrown into that deep chasm on Starkiller Base and got stabbed by Kylo Ren. If you look at characters like Luke, who fell in a deep chasm in Empire, Darth Maul, who fell in a deep chasm in Phantom Menace, and Palpatine, and now they're looking at, of course, Mace Windu, all these different characters have survived these different falls. So when we look at the new, you know, Star Wars universe, it really is a big deal. It really is a very big strategy by Disney in order to attract many of the older fans. And the fact that there's going to be a Darth Vader side story, definitely, of course, it's going to connect to the planned Darth Vader TV series, which is really a Jedi Purge TV show that's going to feature Darth Vader on the side. So anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Again.